How are you? Hope all of you are fine and safe at your home. Students, today we will start our chapter number 3, A Little Girl. Now before reading of that chapter, do you feel you know your parents better now than you were much younger? Perhaps you now understand reasons for some of their actions that used to upset you earlier. कि क्या कभी आपको ऐसा लगता है कि जो आपके पेरेंट्स हैं वो अब ज्यादा बेटर हैं जब आप यंग थे उसके कंपैरिजन में, या अब आप ऐसा अंडरस्टूड करने लगे उस रीजन को कि जो कुछ एक्शंस थे जो आपको पहले अपसेट करते थे. नाउ दिस इज स्टोरी अबाउट अ लिटिल गर्ल हुज फीलिंग्स फॉर हर फादर चेंज फ्रॉम फियर टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग विल प्रोबेबली फाइंड इन एवरी होम. कि ये स्टोरी एक ऐसी छोटी लड़की की है जो अपने फादर से बहुत डरती है, फियर रहता है, लेकिन वो फियर जो है वो चेंज होता है अंडरस्टैंडिंग में. तो ये एक तरह की ऐसी कंडीशन है स्टूडेंट्स जो हर एक घर में होती है. सो वी रीड दिस चैप्टर एंड आई गिव यू द समरी ऑफ दैट लेसन सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टूड इट. नाउ दिस इज द स्टोरी ऑफ अ लिटिल गर्ल केजिया. केजिया वॉज अ लिटिल गर्ल. She had her father, mother, grandmother and a cook named Alice in the house. She was mortally afraid of her papa. She tried to avoid him. Every morning he came into her room to give her a kiss, but the kiss had no warmth. She also bade him goodbye. She felt great relief when he left for office. Now, her father was a short-tempered person. He was so big, his hands, his neck and his mouth, all were big. He appeared like a giant to the little girl. In the evening, father came home and started giving orders. He asked for a tea and his newspaper and his slippers. He demanded prompt service. Mother asked Kezia to take off her father's boot. But Kezia was so very afraid of him that she couldn't speak properly. She would stutter. He asked her why she looked so miserable. Now, on Sunday afternoons, the grandmother would send Kezia to the drawing room to talk with her parents. But Kezia always found the mother reading and her father sleeping on the sofa. When awake, he would compare her to a brown owl. Now, one day, her grandmother told her that her father's birthday was next week and she should give him a surprise gift. She could make a pin cushion. Kezia worked hard. She got a piece of silk and stitched its 3 sides. The next step was to stuff it with some soft material. She looked for waste paper bits. She walked into her parents' bedroom. She saw nice paper sheets on the table. She tore them all into tiny pieces and prepared the cushion. She had no idea how important those papers were. They had on them a speech of the father for the port authority. Now that night there was a hue and cry in the house. Everybody was looking for those important sheets of papers. Mother questioned Kezia about them. The little one admitted she had torn them to pieces. She was dragged down to the drawing room to face her father. She was then put to bed. Father went into the room with a ruler. He gave a few cuts of cane on her rosy palms. She cried bitterly. She asked grandmother what God made fathers for. Grandmother tried to console her and make her forget the incident. But Kezia could never forget the unkindness of her father. On seeing him, she always put both her hands behind her back. One evening, she saw the family of Mr. McDonald who lived next door. He had 5 children. He was a very loving father who used to play with the little ones. He was very forgiving, tolerant and cheerful. This convinced Kezia that all fathers were not alike. Some were loving, others were cruel. As you see here, there is Mr. McDonald and their 5 children. Now one day mother had to be taken to hospital. Grandmother also went with her. Kezia was left alone in the house under the care of the cook Alice. She had no problem during the daytime, but she was put to bed, she grew afraid. She often used to have bad dreams. She would see a butcher holding a knife, smiling dreadfully and coming towards her. She cried out for grandma. That night also she had such a fearful dream. Now her father heard her cry. He came to her room with a candle. He lifted her and carried her to his own bedroom. Kezia crept close to him and put her head under his arm. Father told her to rub her feet with his legs and get them warm. Now father was tired, so he dozed off, but Kezia had a funny feeling of sympathy for her father. She felt poor father was not giant-like or hard. He worked hard all day. Being tired, he could not be playful like Mr. McDonald. He was rightly angry because she had torn his important papers. She forgave him and began to love him again. She told him that he had got a big heart indeed. So here, students, this is the feeling of Kezia about her father, which changes fear into understanding. So you have to read this lesson and try to understand it once again.